Yeah, it may be possible to build. No, there's no boats, man.
I think there will be. How could they not have boats?
Yeah, lead the bird to the T-Rex and see if they fight. Dude, a woolly mammoth. Hit the woolly mammoth. The woolly mammoth eventually will aggro onto the T-Rex, or lead it to the T-Rex. Dude, I gotta see if they'll fight.
Hey, Bloodcrow, quick question. If we started wanting servers for other games, could we attach that to this particular server?
Well, the T-Rex is going after the woolly mammoth.
Oh, yeah, they are fighting right now, dude. They're fighting right now. They're fighting right now.
I led the bird as close to them as I could.
Fucking bird's after me now, bro. Diving. Take a chance with the damn shark. Oh my god, I got the T-Rex and the bird to fight.
Nice.
Or the bird and the... Oh, and the Megalodon still came after me last, like, bitch, you ain't going nowhere. You're dying too.
Oh, that's fucked up.
Oh, dude, I don't care. Hold on, let me respawn. Let me respawn. I gotta see if I spawn near it. Yeah, I did. Alright, dude, I gotta see if this bird wins or the T-Rex, or the Megalodon, I mean. Dude, this Megalodon better win, dude. Seriously. I'd rather deal with a Megalodon than that damn bird, bro.
I know, that bird.
That bird is so annoying.
Yeah, that bird is a bitch.
The T-Rex at least will knock you forward really super far, you know, and you have a chance of surviving. Yeah. I want to see who's winning, this T-Rex or this woolly mammoth. Where the hell is it at? Dude, I forgot. They were like right up here at this coastline somewhere. In the tree lip.
I think the T-Rex may have run because the T-Rex is down here attacking something else. Unless that's another T-Rex.
Let me see. No, the woolly mammoth is still alive, bro. No, that's a Triceratops.
Alright, I'm not wearing underwear anymore.
Yeah, it killed the woolly mammoth, I think. Dude, I think it's eating dodo birds.
It was going after one of the duckies.
Yeah, I think it ate the I think it ate it, dude. Okay. Oh, dude, let me lead it down here. There's a Triceratops and a turtle. Come on, bitch. Come on, bitch.
Hey. This will make you laugh, dude.
Hey,
dead
short
bird.
Arms. Short arms. Hey, bro, can you reach the top shelf for me? Put you in the face. Shit. Oh, that got his attention.
Wow, they should make the bigger the tree, the more
bird got his ass kicked.
Oh, okay. Four dodo birds, a triceratops, and a turtle versus a T-Rex. Who will win? Yeah, the bird was flying underwater.
Hey, Grim.
I think the bird got killed, dude, honestly.
The bird died. I was just up there. The bird's dead.
Alright, I want to help out this,
So.
He's on you, man.
Bloodcrow.
What's up?
Okay, if... We're using the game server for Ark. Can we add more games to that particular server or no?
Oh, like to that account? Yeah. You can add more servers to it.
I wonder what would happen if we lead him out into the water a bit. I wonder if we can get a T-Rex and a Megalodon to fight.
No, what I meant is that particular... Yeah. That account, you
can
buy
that
game server, right?
Wait, say that again?
Okay. What I mean is, yeah, we can add more people. Can we add more games to that exact same account?
More games?
Yeah, like if you... Okay, say we're not playing Ark, but we're
best follow what you're saying. Counter-Strike or something, right? They're the same?
Yeah.
Yeah. Dude, it spawned me right next to the base. That was cool. Man, I gotta run all the way back down there again.
You're not using a bed yet?
No, I'm having fun. Screw you.
Well, is there anything left attacking it? Are the freaking dodos.
What? Oh my god, dude.
It's eating everything else, dude.
You know what we should do? You know what we should do? We should go back over there, punch a bunch of crap, right? Make sure we can outrun it, though. Lead it to the T-Rex and let all of them fight the T-Rex.
Yeah,
like, I just got how much it would take to take out a T-Rex.
Like, literally, like, force everything to run at the T-Rex, pretty much, and charge
see
it.
See what it would take to take out the T-Rex.
Well, we know that three of those, the ones that, like, the tails have, like, the little balls on the end of it or whatever. What are they called?
Stegosauruses?
Yeah. Three of those will kill a T-Rex. I'm just going to swim across. I'm pretty sure a shark is going to come here in a minute. I don't see none right now. But I'm sure.
Literally, like, climb up onto a rock and it's floating in the air on the non-accurate graphics.
Alright. I'm going to laugh if I get across to this damn side of this island over here. I already know what's over here, so. You're on. You are. Oh, you're so dead. Yeah. I don't doubt it. Oh, yep. Snuck up behind me, you bitch.
The T-Rex is now spinning around in circles trying to get this bloody dodo.
They're probably not going to add the server until, I think, 6 a.m. 6 or 8 a.m. But I'm going to be here, Bloodcrow. I will be here. Oh my god, it's walking at me.
Megalodon fighting something? I think it's... Is that turtle fighting a megalodon? What the hell is this? Hold on. What is this? So it's really a dynamic game if you think about it. I mean, like a turtle's over here fighting the hell out of a megalodon, bro.
Yeah, this turtle they be fighting a bloody T-Rex, too.
Coming, turtle.
Oh my god, I'm collecting so much hide right now, Bloodcrow. On the way to you guys, I'm being extremely cautious. And just gathering resource hide right now. I'm probably gonna have like 50 or 60 hide by the time I get to you guys if this keeps up.
What are you killing for the hide?
I'm killing a bunch of dodos, they're everywhere.
Dodos. He's such a dirt old man.
That side of the island, that's the only thing we were missing the early game was dodos.
Right now, I've 16 out of 3 dodos.
I'm gonna go fight a scorpion.
Are you still there, Grim?
Yeah.
Hey, when we do get going on this other server, you want to work with me as like a hunter-gatherer, like, you know, for, we'll like kill the shit for the hides and meat. And work on taming.
Okay, I'll be honest with y'all. I think the first thing we should probably do, like we need to have like two people gather. You know, one person build. Like I can help build, of course, and gather, of course, you know. But like two people help me, and then like two people go do like the hunter gathering, and whoever's hunter and gathering, like there needs to be a tamer with y'all.
Yeah,
so that way, not
one
matter
person
what,
needs to be a tamer.
Yeah.
What?
He You know me, I figure armaments are going to be heavy as shit, so I'm going to be going weight, some health.
Actually, let me die real quick again. I want to check something.
Holy shit, I just spotted four freaking megalodons.
They're not nasty, they just want a hug.
Alright.
What is the Predator X, man? I never heard of that.
Predator X for what?
Predator X in this game.
I think that's one of the boss spawn mobs.
Oh, that's probably the ultimate life form.
There's multiple different ones.
I know, but there's like one ultimate life form.
It's the most powerful marine reptile ever.
Is that the new one coming in?
It's the Pilosaurus.
That's probably going to take a server of people to knock out and tame if it's tameable.
Dude, there's like six freaking...
Oh my god.
Good god.
Yeah. I got three megalodons sitting right in front of me. Right
I got
now.
Six sitting right in front of me and they're all fighting.
Dude, look at it. Okay, I want to tell you something. Look. Okay, so this thing here, right, was 49 feet long and 45,000 pounds and had 30 centimeter, 12 inch long teeth. It's subject to say that it could have had more crushing power than a Tyrannosaurus Rex.
Oh my god.
That's what the Predator X is, dude. So it would be definitely it'd be about the same size, if not bigger than the
Tyrannosaurus Rex.
No, the other one, Megalodon.
Oh, okay. Alright, I'm at 113 weight. At 150, I get bogged down. So. Yeah, I'm freezing.
Yeah, the giant whale thing. That's a good way to look at it, Cardigan. Yeah, what is it called? Oh, it's the giant whale. Yeah, the giant whale with teeth.
Yeah, hey, Bloodcrow, I don't get it, but my water is glitching.
What's it doing?
It's flickering in and out constantly. It's never really? Solid. Yeah. I'm on my way to you guys.
Damn. I'm actually trying to swim to the island again. Like, literally, the one place I know that you can swim to from the base of the island is directly across. But I know that there's no, whatchamacallit's in there.
Yeah, that's the only problem I'm having getting in the servers, because it's not up. Up today. I got in a local game.
I don't know how it's not up to date either.
Water's so cold, it's literally killing me swimming across.
Uh-huh. I think I killed it and harvested everything I could from it all in one shot. Okay. Not weird or crazy at all.
What can we do? What can we do? What can we do? Anthony, how many bows can you make?
Let me see. I can make another one. I can make almost two of them right now.
You know what I just realized too, Bloodcrow?
What?
That if I could go over to the ESO and see how many of my old buddies are into this game eventually if we needed to. And I could probably pull 15 to 30 good PvPers if they play this game and like it.
That's crazy.
Well,
like hardcore PvPers.
Like, we're not even like PvPing just yet. Like, this game is, I'm like, ugh. I gotta have that server.
Well, here's what I'm thinking. Anthony, if you can get to us, God. Dude, I have to level up before I can do anything else, okay? I didn't, like, kind of waste some of my points, like, goofing around. It doesn't matter if it's today or tomorrow. Eventually, we're going to have a server, a new server. I'm thinking that if you get over here, dude, we have so many flintheads. We could easily go out and get some stuff, and we can make some bow and arrows. We need to go hunt a few eggs, bro. Like, three or four, we're sitting there with bow and arrows, just like, you know. Guys, I'm going to turn the light off. That way I can kind of like see the game more. If I can focus on the game more than I am the light above me, I probably won't be so damn tired. Because I keep looking up at that light and it's like zoning me out. So let me turn that off. So that means the green screen is going to look like crap in a minute, okay? So give me just a second. Let me turn the light off.
Oh, shit. Oh, it fucking killed me, and I'm not too far from the base either. God damn it. Fucking scorpion. Yeah, I was right there at the base, guys. I was, like, in distance from you guys. God damn it.
Fuckers out cold, Terry.
I can never make it to the fucking base safely.
I got that one dildo off of you. I came up on you while you were fighting.
I've got a full body, full of equipment. The goddamn scorpion took me out.
Oh, there we go.
Same what's around.
Yeah, Camelot, dude, I'm tired. I'm doing everything right now, Camelot, I can do to stay awake right now, honestly. Because I am...
Go and grab some drink.
I got Taylor's thing over here right now, but, like, dude, I'm, like, I'm just tired. Like, I am just tired. Like, I didn't really sleep, like, that last time. When I tried to stay up, I didn't really sleep that long last time, so.
I slept too much. I slept 15 straight hours. Like, I'm always dead to the world when I go to sleep, too, which is bad.
There.
Well, Troll Island has a white drop. Over there by you guys is a blue drop or a white drop. Can't really tell. I have no gear. Oh, motherfucking scorpion right there at my goddamn body.
Alright. I don't have any coffee. Eat some food, I can do that. Cause I'm pretty sure it's gonna, maybe even what Anthony said, where's game servers located? Hold on, that's a good question. I just now thought of it. Let me see, where are they located?
Dude, I think that thing ate my body.
Of course it did.
This is such bullshit.
Oh,
I'm screwed, a raptor just found me.
Run, Forrest, run!
You see. Let's get it on. That's what I can do. It's a music one. I got the music one.
You up early? Yeah, the Nord. I haven't gone to bed yet. I started. Oh, that's right. OBS had to reconnect, so I lost my total time. I've been up for something like almost 10 hours.
Well, that's the thing. I don't think it's going to be until, you know, in the morning. Might as well I'll go to sleep and get up and be refreshed then instead of
I'm
even more tired when it finally gets up.
Hey, Bloodcrow, did you throw a ticket out?
Dude, there's nobody there this time.
Mm-hmm. Game servers runs 24/7 support.
Yeah, right, I'm assuming they have to go to Valve to get their server or somebody.
Nope, they host their own data centers and they get all their stuff the same way I have mine for setting up a freaking server if I wanted to run it just to test mods and crap. Basically, using what's known as the Steam command line tool, and all they have to do is run a script. It downloads all the files to the server, and then their scripts hook it all into the web-based control panel.
Yeah, it literally should be like a 10-minute job, and that would be like, you know, for them to log in, do the thing, let it load, test it to make sure, like ping it, make sure it's all working, and then like for us to actually probably be able to see it a minute or two later, but for some reason it's taking a long time to do it right now. But you know, it is super late. I mean, I do have to give them some credit because it could just be like less than a handful of people, and they have lots of servers going up all the time, dude. So, you know, I gotta give them a little bit of credit, a little bit of slack. But if this would have been around noon,
I just don't think. Yeah, like I said, I don't think it's gonna be anytime soon.
Well, if this was around noon or something, I'd have been like, yeah, you know.
Oh yeah, during the day.
All right, Cardigan, dude. Like, I am... Hold on. I hate to say it, dude. I'm at 20 hours. And at this point...
4 hours away.
Yeah, I'm 4 hours away, but... It's going to be probably that long for the server to go. I don't want to be exhausted and only be able to play for 2 minutes. I'd rather go to sleep and have my wife wake me up at 8 in the morning.
That's what I'm saying. Get some rest now. That way we're refreshed when the servers do come up. That's what I'm about to do. I'll just mess with it when I get up.
I'm not going to sleep. Bloodcrow, do I just log in and check the server from there?
Yeah. Put in that login and put in that password. Just like I said, don't change it. And that's
can you,
it.
Can you send it to me through Skype so I have it forever?
Yeah, I guess. I sent it to you in TeamSpeak, though.
I know. I have it in the TeamSpeak. But I have two different messages, two different conversations.
He can't be bothered to write down something with a pen on paper. Are you kidding? Jeez, I'm peaceful. What are you thinking about?
Clown will eat me.
Oh. Okay. Jeez. People are getting angry now.
No, that's just too archaic for you. I know. I mean...
Hey, I started going electronic, and everything I used to do went out the window if it wasn't electronic.
I know, that's what I could...
I upgraded my entire life. Give me a second. I got it here, then. I'll just write it all down. Because somebody's giving me an ass chin.
I think that's what I'm going to do. I think I'm just going to go ahead and call it. We're checking the clamp A scene. It says pending installed. Dallas. Yeah, Cardigan. Yeah, dude. Yeah. I accidentally selected the 40 man instead of the 50, but it can easily be upgraded. But that's something we'll have to upgrade during the day. Or overnight, you know. But, 40 is still good enough. I meant to do 50. But,
40 is good to start with, I
think. 40 is good to start with.
We'll see how it goes,
It's pretty much $10 increments. $10 increments is what it boils down to. But, right now, all we got to do is just give it time, and it'll, But, it's pending.
Oh my god, those birds.
Yep, I'm gonna call it. I'm calling it. I don't want to be tired of playing it and only be able to play for 4 hours or 2 hours or 1 hour.
Already be delirious and like.
Yeah, and already be delirious and ready to just be like, I'd rather go ahead and just say, do it.
Are you serious? These things can fly underwater and come after us? Are you kidding me?
Nope.
Are you fucking kidding me? Oh my god, I was right there at the base.
I swear to god, with those big bird fuckers, once we get our tech up to the point where I can get a minigun, I'm killing every single one of them I find.
All right, the tame guys. Ones we got.
User disconnected from your channel.
And Bloodcrow just left, right? Yep. Hey, Scott Plant, you still there?
Yes, sir.
What you doing?
I'm going over my budgets. Crying myself.
You're crying that your wallet just became several times smaller.
Oh, I'm so far in debt right now, it's not even fun.
Yeah, I don't like thinking about how much you're in debt when you literally just dropped that much money.
That's why I'm in so much debt.
Oh my god, your credit is on the ridiculous. It's over 9,000.
Oh, my business credit right now is stretched to the limit. I had to actually take out some personal credit cards to cover some of these expenses.
Oh wow.
Which is fine. I know it's going to get paid back. It's just I need to wait for the busy season to kick off, and it's starting to, but the revenue just hasn't rolled in yet. I had money held back.
This is around November and shit. For those hunting lodges and stuff, it's going to be November and stuff.
It's not just hunting, though. It's a sportsman's lodge. It's mostly fishing, actually. So that's already started, but it's summer vacation time is what I'm waiting for. That's when it really gets busy for all my hotels. I mean, starting second week of June, all of a sudden everything kicks off and occupancies go through the roof, especially in Milwaukee. I have three of my hotels are in the Milwaukee area, and it's called the City of Festivals. Every weekend they have a different party down at the lakefront. It's all ethnic festivals, like German Fest, Fest Italiana, Arabian Nights, Asian Moon, you know, all these different festivals they have down at the lake. And they're just starting to kick off next weekend, so I think next weekend is like
I'll be checking that server.
Labor Fest and Harley weekend. So that one of my hotels is 2 miles away from Harley's corporate headquarters, and so it's very busy.
Thank you for the support. Hell yeah. Good morning, Camelot. Hell yeah, guys.
I'm actually starting to see daylight. I gotta keep an eye on the time. I got a morning meeting with the managers of this property.
Alright, I'm looking at it right now. It says pending.
You guys are making me seriously consider want to buy this game now.
Hey, do it. Do it. It'll be the best
outstanding already,
ever.
Dude.
I'm not a huge fan of the genre, and like Rust and stuff like that was never a huge game for me. DayZ was never a big game for me. I hated all the PvP stuff. That was the problem. Like, I'd go on to a Rust server and I get fucking creamed right away.
Well, we're going to be able to control this. That's the thing. We're having it's a community thing, and we're going to have like some bylaws and stuff like that.
Well, and that's the thing is that if I can, because I didn't have a group of people who I played with.
Exactly. I wouldn't have played this either if I didn't have a group. You can ask them. Remember GameCube? I was like, I don't even want to play it. But then when everybody else was getting it, I'm like, oh, well, I got people to play with. I like that kind of game. But yeah, I don't
know what
type of games. And this game literally pushes you towards being in a tribe. I don't see how you'll be able to. People won't be able to solo in this game, really.
Like,
unless
soloing?
You're just some hardcore survivor type thing and you want to, like, go rough it, you know.
Mention not. No, the giveaway has not started, my friend. Man, there are a lot
it's
of people.
Like
here.
Some hardcore fucking Bear Grylls shit.
I mean, you just want to get in and run and try to see how long you can survive. And if you, like, restarting every 5 minutes or so.
Well, at least you keep your level. That's the good thing. As long as you keep your character.
Well.
And I haven't respawned near my cave at all. DJ Shadow, I see it, man. And I say thank you. Just wait for the alert to pop up. It happens anywhere from a few seconds to a few minutes, guys. But damn, I'm excited. I'm waiting on the server.
And I'm sorry for giving you shit, Genki. I've been getting salty all damn day, and I apologize.
No problem, man. I'm
frustrated. I hear everybody playing, and I'm like, can't even fucking do nothing. I'm fucking like, I want to play too. I'm getting mad at everybody.
Yeah, guys, mention not. It says 2.5 hours, but I've been up for 10.5. OBS decided to derp out, disconnect, and then reconnect. So I lost the entire time that I've been up. I've been up since about 7:30 Eastern Standard Time. So, okay, so it's like seven and a half hours since I started.
Oh, and Grim.
Yeah.
After we got our basic tools and shit out in the beginning, I got a plan for getting a decent stockpile of hide and meat early game so we can tame us some raptors first. Or not raptors, but like a couple dillos each or something. But it involves taking run speed the first couple.
Hey guys, can you hear me pretty well? Can you hear me really well?
But if you noticed how we had two
speed?
Sides to our little
like,
thing.
Those guys are talking. Can you hear me pretty well? Do I need
we
to
had a good amount of herbivores, but then we came into where the,
closer
you know,
to me.
The carnivores were.
I've got my microphone sitting over here.
And like how
side.
I pulled that T-Rex and those stegosauruses.
So.
Like, and that also gives the time. That also gives, you know, the time we're, you know, getting our early game shit straightened out. The you know the dinos around us got time to level up, and I want to do like the same thing though. I want to bait a couple decent sized predators into a bunch of herbivores. I think it's easier than unless we get lucky with dodos though. That's only because that where we was at, there was no fucking dodos, man. And that's your meat and hide early game. You know what I mean?
Oh yeah.
Because you can just run up and whack them.
That fucked up thing is when I screwed up and hit new survivor and I spawned there on northern coast, every freaking time it would respawn me, I was seeing nothing but damn dodos.
So maybe that's what we'll need to do too. Maybe if we that's what we could do. If we run into that again, maybe like me and you, if you want to do this, you want to do like the same thing, or you want to do something else? Would you rather
DJ Shadow, thank you for that support, my friend. Thank you for the follow.
Honestly, right now, I'm not even sure.
Oh, right.
I'm starting to get tired of your shit.
So if you talk and he talks, we can't hear you.
I've already been through 4 cans of Pepsi, 6 cups of coffee.
Oh my god, I'm dropping frames.
I'm sitting here freaking damn rocking back and forth in my damn chair.
Oh my god, I'm dropping frames really bad. Oh my god, I have no frames. What's going on? What's happening? Okay, now I'm not dropping frames anymore. What the fuck was that about? Okay. Hold on, guys. I'm working with my headset here. You know, you guys see it? It's quite literally, it's broken. It's a Turtle Beach Air Force Recon. It is just smashed.
Here I am sitting here eating my dinner.
Oh, I'm wide awake. I've been pumping myself full of hotel coffee.
It's free, right?
No.
Not for him. I pay for it.
I know. That's why I made the joke.
Shit, half the time in normal hotels nowadays, it ain't.
It isn't all mine.
It isn't every single damn one I've stayed in. Hell, 90% of them got fucking coffee makers in the damn rooms with at least two or three freaking pre-filled filters.
Every one of my hotels has got the coffee packs in the room, two regular, two decaf, coffee maker, refrigerator, microwave, and there's always coffee in the lobby as well.
Okay, can you guys hear me better? That's you hear me better? Is this working?
Not really. I mean,
hello? Is this thing on?
I have two stars, I have two 3-stars, and now I have 2 4-stars.
Congrats on the 4-star work, Scott Plants.
Well, they're not official 4-stars yet. I have to get them rated after I get them opened, but they will be.
Nice. Be making more money.
Well, that's why I can go into so much debt now.
Hey, Scott Plants, like I said, you know, if this all works out and stuff, you know exactly what I plan on doing, man. I'll find a way to come up there and have a party in one of your hotels, man.
Well, half of them are ready for LAN parties. I have the meeting rooms all wired, but my 2 2-stars and one of my 3-stars, the meeting rooms, I haven't retrofitted them yet. It'll be next year when I do that, probably.
Nice. Nice, Scott Plants. Alright, hey guys, this is literally what you're looking at when you see me talking. You see that? I've got my headphones literally stacked on each other because you can't wear the headset anymore. It's literally broken into several pieces. And that's why I contacted Sadus about one of their headsets. You know, they have a free headset thing, and apparently they've got the best flexibility. Yeah, I tried to contact Sadus about their headsets, and I really want one.
I'm using an old Xbox 360 headset right now.
Nice.
I've been loyal to Logitech for a while.
I've been running Turtle Beach.
I got a Turtle
home,
Beach,
but... At home, I have a Blue Yeti, and I use a set of Skull Candy earbuds when I do podcasts and whatnot, but I'm a Logitech man. My gaming rig at home is, I got the G710 Plus, and then I have the G500S gaming mouse.
Nice.
The Logitech mouse or one of the Razer ones?
Logitech, the G500S, the one you can adjust the weight on, and I can adjust the DPI and everything else. It's really nice.
Yeah, I got the G602.
Nice, nice.
And actually, I'm gonna remap the DPI buttons because I don't really change it much. Usually, I have to go to one setting and stick it there.
Yeah, I kind of am too. It depends on the game, though. I have some games where it seems like mouse sensitivity is an issue, so I can set it. You know, in different screens, it seems like the mouse is more sensitive in one screen and less than another. So, you know, it's so nice to have the buttons on top to be able to adjust the DPI on the fly. And you can just remap it to whatever levels you want.
Yeah, I just don't ever use them, so I might as well set them to something I can use them for.
Yeah, the default settings, there's not much of a difference between the lowest and the highest, but you can definitely change it.
Mine goes up to like one of the highest DPIs of any mouse.
I don't like it too high. I'm an old man. I sometimes get the shakes, and I don't want to have a real sensitive mouse.
That's why I can't play first-person shooters for shit anymore.
Except my computer's gonna force me to reboot.
Let me guess, Windows 8.1 update?
Yep.
Oh god, yeah, Windows 8.
Yeah, I decided to stay on Windows 8 until it forced the update.
Yeah, you did say you just reinstalled it the other day. I'm sticking with 7 for a while. I got an archaic machine, so 10 would just be like running a game on my machine.
Eh, not really. I've had 10. I had 10 running on an old ass HP DV6 dual core laptop, and about the only problem I had was with the video drivers. Because anything based on flash hardware acceleration wouldn't work, and that's just because of the damn beta drivers that AMD gave to Microsoft to put out for it, because they still haven't put out a decent driver yet with full support for Windows 10.
Oh yeah, their drivers broke my graphics card for like a month and a half before the new driver.
No, I remember it was the whole power thing. If that was going on from day one, that was probably the main thing. I highly doubt it's a driver or Windows issue.
No, but the screen tearing. What the hell? This dude saw me from so far away.
Nope. Well, that's alright. The build before the current one that's out of Windows 10. Microsoft actually ended up putting a statement out saying that users with AMD graphics cards not to install it, and they put the statement out after people had already downloaded it and installed it.
Yep.
And it was actually causing the GPUs on the card when you load up Microsoft Edge, which is what was Project Spartan, their new browser, because they're completely getting rid of Internet Explorer, which for me, yeah, it's about damn time. But it was causing an issue with hardware acceleration, and it would literally cause the GPU on the card to crash, and the symptoms of it mimicked identically of a video card that just fried itself.
Oh my god, that's scary.
I freaked out because I've only had this Gigabyte R7250 2GB overclock edition. I have only had this card for 4 months. Okay, I got the build installed. I went to go and download Google Chrome. It loaded that freaking flash animation that's on the Chrome website, and next thing I know, my Scream does the multicolor rainbow streaks, flashes white, goes black, reports no signal.
Oh my god, a saber tooth killed me too. Are you fucking kidding me? What the fuck am I not gonna run into on the way to the base now? Oh my god. It's a struggle to get to you guys. I'm gonna go back to my other side. But they spawned me in the... I'm in the exact fucking same spot now. I've been spawning in the same spot for I don't know how long now.
When I first got in the server yesterday, I swear I died in the same exact spot four times by the same freaking bird. When my video card did that, I was freaking. I went and I dug in my damn closet. I got the box out. I still got the box sitting right here on the table. Checking my warranty status on it and everything else.
Anytime you buy hardware, it's got a one-year warranty.
Gigabyte on this card, they actually gave a three-year on it.
Really? Nice.
Yeah, I got a three-year on my video card. I got 2 years on the motherboard, 5 years on the liquid cooler, and 3 years on the power supply.
Nice. I need flint. Okay, got it. Oh, man. I don't know what happened a few minutes ago. I just had, like, I was dropping frames like a true champion.
Yeah, I saw that.
I dropped 1,900 frames. There must have been a random Steam download. That was critical.
Yeah, I saw that for a minute here. I thought OBS was going to drop out.
Yeah, I know. No, OBS wasn't going to drop out. It was just going to, like, lag out on OBS, which is what it did. I went from 2,600 bits to zero real fast, and that only happens with Steam.
Yeah, Steam gets so bad. I don't know what it is in the latest versions of Steam. But Steam will get so bad at times downloading that it basically DOSes my own goddamn computer off the internet outside of its transfer.
Yeah, that's what I mean, is like you have all this download speed to use the internet, but the moment you use any upload, your computer is just like, nope. But like, I have 100 download and yet Steam is only running at 600 megabytes. It's like, okay, well, where's my other 94? Where the fuck is it? You know what I mean?
Exactly. I mean, I don't have that fast of a connection, but I'm on a 50 down, 20 up, and...
Dude, I would kill to have your connection right now. I want 20 up so I can stream off of freaking XSplit to Hitbox and Steam at the exact same time. I would kill for your connection right now. Because I split my internet between my wireless router and me, so I get 50 megabytes download no matter what, tops, and my wireless router gets 50, but it actually only gets up to like 35 to 40 megabytes because of the router. So
yeah, see, that's the messed up thing with mine. No matter what the hell I do with my router, and I still say, and I've had people tell me, no, it's not your router. I still say it's my damn router, though, because connect direct to my modem, my business gateway, I'll freaking max out doing 40 to 42 on freaking Steam on download.
Yeah.
Through the freaking router.
Wait, 40 to 42 megabytes?
I'll pull anywhere between 40 to 42 megabits per second with a direct connection to my gateway.
I have a direct connection to my desktop, and I only I've only ever received 6 megabytes download, 6.8 max on Steam.
Yeah, there's actually a Steam actually limits their traffic, which is kind of messed up considering like where I live at. The CDN that I pull from is actually run by my cable provider, is actually run by Comcast. And Comcast has actually been jumping their ass about limiting the bandwidth on the CDNs that they run.
Yeah. Yeah, because it's bullshit. Everyone can run at a higher value, but then when your upload speed and like everything else just cuts off because of that bullshit, that's fucked up.
Oh yeah. Like, but I mean, I've got my QoS settings on this router because the router I have, it's a D4500 Gamer Fuel. And this router, I've actually got it set up to where my computer gets the most bandwidth on the network. Well, my computer, Lee's laptop, and when I had my PS3, everybody else on the wireless was limited to like 25 to 30% of the bandwidth. The rest of it was mine, her laptop, my PlayStation, and with the Gamer Fuel, it automatically detects when you're running a game and will automatically balance the network traffic to reduce lag. Well, it doesn't work that good. Which is part of the reason why I say it's my damn router, because Steam, every time I get a download on Steam, I can't do any damn thing else on my computer internet-wise outside of online streaming radio, anything else, and it's just, hell, Twitch streams, I have to drop them. Normally, I can watch them on Source, no problem. But when I have a Steam download running, I have to drop them all the way to mobile to keep them from constantly buffering.
Oh my god, I hate that.
I want one of the new Netgear Nighthawks.
Are you kidding me? I'm about to level again? I like just leveled like 10 minutes ago, 10, 15 minutes ago.
I might want to get one of the new Nighthawk AC1900s.
What, a router?
Yeah. They're like a $230 freaking router, but they guarantee no matter what you do on your network, if you have a machine or a device that's streaming video in HD, somebody else could be connected, running a game or running a massive download, and you will not lag. They guarantee it, or they will refund your money.
Camelot, yeah. It's a router. They guarantee it to not lag. I like the sound of that, but I would literally have to, at this point, I would have to wait until school starts to buy one, which is still just fine. But damn it, I'm already, like, I'm $1,000 in already, and I can't take from that money too much. I still gotta pay for my truck. I gotta try and move, which I gotta save up for that. Not gonna lie here. If I can grow the community again, if I can grow Twitch like we were in March before my rig went down, I'm gonna literally try and rely on the community just a little bit to give me that little push that I need to help get me moved. 'Cause I can do a lot. I can do everything else. I just need the help to move, because when I do move, I'll be able to have a studio just for the stream. Like a room just for the stream. And that's my plan. It's either that or I make a soundproof room in the basement of wherever I move to next.
quickest way to soundproof. Look for egg crate foam and just freaking either staple it to the walls and the ceiling, or if you can't staple it, double-sided gaffer's tape.
You said double-sided what?
Gaffer's tape. It's what they use on like movie sets and production sets and shit like that for temporarily securing like cabling and shit.
Okay. Yeah, I've got a Belkin router.
So. Yeah, I've had bad experiences with Belkins. I've literally burned out Belkins with the amount of network traffic I have. At any given time, I have over 20 freaking active connections going through my router.
I bought the gaming one from the previous Belkin I had. I have a Time Warner, and they decided to use the cheapest router they could get, like the cheapest modem that had a wireless router in it. I said, nope, don't fucking give me that piece of shit, because the moment it goes wireless, that modem goes wireless, I lose my hardline cable, almost all of it, so I don't want a wireless connection on the modem. And they're like, okay, and then they gave me junk modem, so I bought a badass wireless router and told them to give me a modem that works with my router. Since then, we've upgraded it 3 times, and we've always been moving up since then.
Yeah, that's what I like with my business class to Comcast is I don't really have to worry about. I mean, yeah, I pay a $10 extra month fee, but it's like what I'm running right now is a straight up industry wow. class gateway. It's actually the Netgear CG 30,000 DCR or 3,000 DCR. The damn thing literally looks like it belongs in a freaking server rack.
Why does my guy sound like that? Oh, because I'm fucking thirsty, no wonder. And apparently I'm, like, all hot and bothered.
That's something I'm looking forward to in Windows 10 rolls, because with the previews I've been running, I've been doing extensive network tests, and I've literally transferred over 2 terabytes across my internal network, and at any given time I can turn around and run a 20 gigabyte transfer across the network. Hold on a second. Cat being an asshole. But at any given time I could run a 20 to 30 gigabyte transfer across my network, and it takes less than 10 minutes.
That's crazy.
They've completely rebuilt the network stack in Windows 10. It blows everything out from Windows 7 all the way through Windows 8.
And you said just for how it works with things?
Oh, yeah. I mean, it's like with DirectX 12 that's coming.
You know, DirectX 12 is amazing.
Yeah, the whole thing is basically going to be doing what AMD started with Mantle, of straight hardware level access directly to the OS and the software without having all the API calls and everything else.
Yeah. What I'm going to like is the fact that you can take 2 completely different graphics cards, bridge them, and it like works extremely well with DirectX 11.
Yeah, that's something I was actually surprised when they announced that. They actually demoed it. I actually seen a video where Microsoft demoed it. They had a GTX
960 and an R9 290X in the same box combined. And I'm just sitting there like, huh?
We've like, it makes no sense.
For years.
Yeah. And they finally made it available. So all those people with like stored up graphics cards now have like better access because they can use their full hardware to the best networking ability possible.
And I mean, even on my system, with as old as the processor is, and I mean, like I said, it's only like a 3-year-old processor, but still. Market-wise, price-wise, I've seen the chip that I have in here, which is the Intel Xeon X3470. I've seen those suckers go as high as $500 for that chip, and that's a 3-year-old chip.
Wow.
I actually got lucky as hell and had a local shop here that had like 20 of them they bought in a auction from a shop that was going out of business. And they were selling them for $89 a chip.
Wow.
I couldn't pass that up considering I ended up upgrading this system from an i3-550.
That's insane.
Now, what's insane is if I tell you how this system originally started. Originally started out of a gateway that was rescued out of a house fire. I ended up replacing the motherboard because one of the hard drive controllers went out. Bought a new video card to put in it. And then finally, I come across that sale on those chips, and I was like, you know what, screw it. I'm getting off this i3, and if I'm doing anything, I'm grabbing that, because that's even used. The lowest I've seen used is like $238. I was like, screw it, I'm buying it. She wants off this laptop, and I can't blame her. I spent enough time on a so-called gaming laptop from Acer that within a year and 6 months fried itself due to a very poorly designed cooling system.
Well, you got to remember, laptops also, like, even if you get the Razer gaming laptop, streaming itself, if you go to stream on one, because it is doable, I can stream off mine, because I have an integrated card, and I have a supported gaming card, and I have to play games that are like, you know, cheap. However, it's gonna burn out. The streaming aspect is just so intensive on a laptop that you kind of like gotta worry about investing in a second laptop in the future.
Yeah, the one I had a AMD A8 4500M had an integrated, I think it was a 70, it was either 7650 or 7850, and then had a dedicated 7850 1 GB on it. And, I mean, it wasn't that bad of a machine up until Acer decided, oh, well, we're going to pinpoint areas in the clear plastic shielding that they put on the bottom of the motherboard, as well as over the hard drive, which is where things were getting really hot.
Yeah.
And saying the discoloration in the clear plastic, which was from heat, was from liquid damage, and voided my warranty.
Oh my god. One way to say they get out of shit.
Yeah. And after all that happened, I come to find out, and if I would have known this beforehand, I would have never bought it. Acer is actually run by Gateway. And I've had nothing problem with Gateway.
I remember when Gateway was new. I was excited to have those things in school.
Oh yeah, the old Gateway 2000 beige towers with the black and white cow cube on the front.
Yeah.
That's all right. My first was a compact Presario.
Nah, I probably got all y'all beat. My actual first computer was a Commodore VIC-20.
No, Atari 800XL. I thought we were just sticking with IBM compatible PCs. I learned how to program in BASIC and Logo on my Atari 800XL.
Nah, I was doing program. I was doing freaking pro. I was doing, oh, God damn it.
One at a time.
I was doing assembly language coding on freaking Commodore VIC-20 when I was 7 years old.
Yeah, I started writing programs when I was 7. I entered my first personally written computer program in my 5th grade science fair. I was 10. I used a combination of BASIC and local programming. I had a cousin who used to give me a video game every time I'd write a program.
Oh, that's awesome.
Yeah, that was motivation. He taught me how to program too, but every time like I'd create like a random number generator or whatever I wrote for a program and I showed it to him, he'd give me a new pirated video game on a big old floppy disk. I'd throw it in my Atari 800XL and play it.
What's really cool is apparently Pit Spawn wants in on this conversation too. He said his first was a TRS-80. I don't know some of this.
Yeah, the good old Radio Shack TSR-80.
Yeah. That was like the generic version of the Commodore, the Atari.
Yup.
Oh my goodness.
It was the bastard child of the family with 32 kilobytes of RAM.
Well, okay.
No, he's right, it was.
Was that really good then?
No, considering 64-bit on the Commodore 64.
Oh. That's terrible.
And the same thing, Atari ran 64 as well. The TRS-80, I think, came out before the other two, but it was kind of like the redhead stepchild of the family.
Ah.
Yep.
He's like, yep. Way to go, Pit
Spawn. And then, of course,
you fit in with the old guys here, bro.
There was the RAM upgrade cartridge. Poor man, I don't know if you're a
chick. Yeah, you could slip in the top of it, yeah. I have it too in the Atari 800XL, you could double your RAM.
And this is a messed up thing. It's really messed up. The cartridges for the VIC-20 and the Commodore 64 were actually interchangeable. A lot of people didn't realize that. And they actually came out with a memory cartridge for them that would actually up the usable RAM from 64 kilobits to 128 kilobits.
Well, there were very few applications back then that needed that much RAM necessarily. I mean, even the higher-end graphics programs and stuff like that weren't necessarily using that much RAM at the time. It was kind of a waste.
Even on the IBM
games, I mean, some of the games you could use it with, and that was it. Because I had one of the RAM extenders from my Atari 800XL, and I rarely ever used it.
Hey, Pit Spawn. You're only, 9 years older than me. I'm 35, I'll be 36 this year.
No, I'm 39, I'll be turning 40 next year.
Look at that, you got some age on these old guys, Pit Spawn. I'm not sure if you want to be proud of that or not.
No, I've aged myself. I mean, I think I'm way beyond my close to 40 at this point.
We already know about you, Scott Plants. I mean, you've got a hotel business, not to mention all that fun money.
No, what fun money now? All my fun money's gone.
I still can't
believe you're tripping. Right now, it's all sitting in a hotel that hasn't opened up yet.
Your trip to Japan sounded so cool, but the reason to go was, like, so lame. I'm sorry.
Well, I had other things I wanted to do there, too. I mean, I still have... I have an apartment in Seoul I need to get rid of still. And I haven't gone back to try to get it listed.
How do you rotate items before you place them?
You'll place it down so it'll lock into place, and then you'll move your mouse left or right, and it'll rotate them. So you've got, like, two clicks. One to place it, and then the second... And before that... You'll rotate and then click again to make it permanent.
When you really want to get into some old school computing, about one of the main things I used in my Commodore VIC 24 was interfaced with a ham radio system doing over the air analog data packet transfer.
We used to do the same thing, but via BBS. It wasn't through ham radio, but we'd handle... That was back in the early concepts of the idea of cloud computing, where you could get multiple computers to be able to crunch a certain packet of data, and so you'd log on via... Like, we had modems, but we didn't have internet. You dial directly into a server, and you'd be able to download the data packet, take it back to your computer, and let it run. And then you'd log back into the BBS, and then you'd update the data and download more and keep doing that.
Need
and it was
more
a way for you to work.
I need
to help them be able to use mass computing, basically, to be able to work through
I
data.
I follow girl streamers. What's up, dude? What's going on? I see you, man. Oh, God. It's so dark, I can't even see the screen.
GameKey. I don't know if this is... If that should be a compliment or an insult right there. Your most recent follow, I follow girl streamers.
Yeah, I know. I was looking at that, and I'm like, thank you anyway. Alright, I follow girl streamers also. Anywhere from a few seconds to a few minutes, the alert system will pick it up and we'll see the effect across the screen. I want to thank you for that. Hang out, stick around, you'll get to see it.
Hell, I still remember back in the day, my first IBM PC, IBM compatible PC I had was a freaking IBM PC XT. With an 8080 processor and an 8088 coprocessor. I think I had 8 megabytes of RAM in the damn thing and a 50 meg hard drive in the fucker. I still remember running Windows 1.0 on that damn thing and using a dial-up modem to connect to the Green Lantern BBS that used to run out of Seattle.
Mine first was an MS-DOS-based system. Didn't even have Windows on it. My uncle, who had passed away, had left it to me in his will. And so I had to learn text-based MS-DOS because I didn't even have Windows for work groups yet. That was a 5 floppy disk install that I didn't have the processor to be able to handle. That was my very first upgrade I had to do, was upgrade that processor so I could put Windows for work groups on it. It was a pirated copy from my mom's work. Went onto their computers and I swiped it off onto 5 floppy disks and put it on the computer at home.
Man, my neighbors are so loud.
Sorry, I can turn my gain down.
Oh no, not you guys, my neighbors. Oh. It sounds like my kids are running around across the entire upstairs. And it's
probably
like the apartments on either side of me. Like, we put a lock on my son's door because we don't need him getting up at 3 in the morning, getting out of his room, and getting into the bathroom or coming downstairs. Like, we had to
reason number 5,432, that I'm glad I didn't have kids. I don't have to put locks on doors.
Yeah, I know, right?
There's footsteps in my house. I got my gun.
Yeah, it's like either your wife got up and went to the bathroom and you look over and she's not there, or two, someone's in your house downstairs.
Well, the first thing I would do to check to see if she's there and see if the dog's there.
is the first, you know, two people in my room that I check to see if I hear footprints. And the next thing I do is I go for my gun and I put the clip in. Because I live in
the city. I follow girl streamers. So thank you for the support and the
vagrants are not
friend.
Uncommon.
Yeah, thank you so much. Yes.
And now that is. I live up here in Spokane, Washington now. Or as people are starting to call it, Spokompton.
Well, our sheriff, Milwaukee County Sheriff David Clark, has told us that 911 is not your best option. That having being armed is your best option in the city of Milwaukee.
That's pretty much what our sheriff has told us here in Spokane County. He goes, average response time is 9 minutes. He goes, within that 9 minutes, you or somebody in your house could be, somebody in your house that you love and care for could be dead. He goes, I'm going to say this, and he goes, they're probably going to have a lot of people that's not going to like it. They're going to complain, everything else. He goes, but I don't care. Arm yourself. He goes, I don't care if it's a knife, sword, gun. Arm yourself. Because you have a better chance of defending yourself and fighting off somebody wanting to either break into your home or cause bodily harm to you faster than us getting there before they do something.
Okay, I don't know about you guys, but here's what I just got from game servers. I mean, it's still pending, but I looked at reported issues, and it says this. We're working to configure this game to be available as soon as possible. We will provide further updates here when available. So we don't have access to the game yet, even though we paid for the server? That's what I'm guessing here.
It's an automated response for whatever ticket he sent in.
Yeah, but that was June 2nd. That was June 2nd.
Well, then that doesn't have anything to do with what we just bought on June 4th. Or 5th, whatever it is now. Second was like Tuesday.
Yeah, they started pre-orders on Tuesday for them.
Guess what just happened?
Huh?
I fucking died again because I was looking at something on the internet.
Oh, shit.
Fucking Sabretooth just wanders over to me and starts mauling me to death. God damn it.
Oh, I had just like, seen it on the stream.
I had, dude, if you guys find my body, I've got like 3 bow and arrows. I've got like 40 fucking arrows. I've got a shitload of resource on my body. I'm a little disappointed with that one because I was so far away from the goddamn Sabretooth, it shouldn't have come near me. And there's a... What? Oh, it's a ducky. Yeah, I had so much shit. God damn it. So not cool. This is not cool at all. It's gonna be daytime soon. Xenos, thank you for that follow, my friend. Yeah, we'll have a server soon, hopefully. By that time, Blanco will be away. I'll probably put some time in on it. I hope to be.
Get some rest now. So what's up?
I hope to be on it soon on the new server, which means I'll have to reset my level. But this server is owned by Vedan. He's another player who gave Bloodcrow and myself access. It's a private server. However, what's really cool about it is we can check things out, see what to expect. You guys get to see firsthand what's going on and what to look forward to.
First IBM PC I had. Originally, it did have DOS on it. Matter of fact, I think it was like DOS 2.0.
My whole deal is, My first computer was the first and only Apple I ever owned. It was an Apple IIc.
Never owned an Apple,
thank
God.
You for that follow. That was thank the first you for one the I ever support, had. My friend. Hell
I didn't know
yeah,
shit
thank
about
you.
Computers when I got it either.
Guys, I'm here 7 days a week.
First and last Apple
7 days
I ever owned was one of the original
iPod shuffles.
I can't stop
playing
Ark. Like a damn pack of fucking gum. Had that sucker for just over a year, and it started giving memory read-write errors, and I just chucked the damn thing off the overpass out the window of my fucking car.
Oh, I got one of those in the supply drop when I was over in Iraq. They was giving them out to everybody in the military.
Yeah, that's where I got mine.
I gave it to a buddy so he could send it to his daughter. I didn't even open the motherfucker.
Yeah, messed up thing is because he got it that way. If anything happened to it, Apple wouldn't honor the damn warranty because, oh, you don't have proof of purchase. Really?
But what if you get it as a gift? How do you have proof of purchase then?
You must have the receipt.
Yeah, you have to have the receipt or get a hold of the person that bought it for you as a gift and have them either send you a copy of their of the receipt if they have it, if they don't, of the credit card transaction if they use a credit card or bank transaction if they use check or a debit card. I'm like, well, what the hell are you supposed to do if they pay fucking cash? Oh, well, we can't help that. There's no way to track that.
Must be a receipt only. That.
Or no, if your company gave it to us. Like, they were gifts from Apple. The one I got, the supply job I had, they had one of those, some earbud company that was coming out with a couple cards for the free music and shit on iTunes, all that. I just told him to send them to his daughters. I didn't even, like I said, that Apple IIc was the first and only Apple product I ever touched. And it was fun back then, you know what I'm saying, totally brand new computer, and, you know, little games to play and stuff, hell yeah. But this was before the whole Windows debacle and Steve Jobs, what he did.
What'd Steve Jobs do?
Well, it's the big ass company that he made it.
Well, yeah, that.
No, he did good. I'm not downing Steve Jobs. I mean, he's a brilliant man. But I think
if you're gonna make blame, it'd be if there's gonna be blame cast on anybody, it should be cast on freaking Bill Gates and Steve Ballmer, considering the fact.
Well, there's no blame. It's in making money.
Well, here's the thing, though. Apple got the idea of the mouse and the graphical user interface from Xerox. Okay, because Xerox, their labs had come up with it. The higher ups at Xerox said, yeah, who the hell's going to use something called a mouse and use something that looks like this? And Apple took it and ran with it. And well, after Apple came out with the first version of Mac OS, Microsoft seen it. And they're just like, oh shit, we're in trouble. And they basically took the actual original versions of Windows 1.0, looked almost identical to the Mac OS. The only difference was, instead of an Apple, it was a Windows logo. And that started the whole rivalry up until the late 90s between Microsoft and Apple, until Microsoft took a majority share in Apple to keep Apple from going bankrupt.
Well, yeah, because you can't own a monopoly.
Save money by doing that. Just think with the whole feud thing that he went kind of crazy with the way that he made Apple products.
It's either I this or I that, or Apple this, Apple that, and only with Apple product.
Yeah, that's
Windows,
the only thing
access
I think where he went wrong. Yeah, people are gonna go with, you know,
whatever they
shit
want.
Shit that does everything, and you can upgrade it yourself. And
Yeah, or you're going to be one of those people like, oh, I swear by Apple, because Apple is the best home entertainment system ever. I can access my phone, computer, and my home surround sound system from my goddamn cell phone, because it's all Apple I everything.
Yeah, well, Apple's about to get screwed on that, because Microsoft's about to pull that with Windows 10. Here's a kicker for you. A lot of people haven't really heard about this. There's a Japanese or Chinese, can't remember. Anyways, cell phone company by the name of Zatomi that Microsoft is working with. They normally do Android phones. Well, they have come. Microsoft and this company has come up with a way, without using emulation or anything, to actually install Windows 10 for phones on Android hardware.
Nice.
Why not just go get a Windows phone?
Right.
I already have one. I have a Nokia Lumia 635.
I've got the 900. I love it. I would never give up my Windows phone.
It's nice integration
into my network. It's like a laptop for me. I have Office and everything else on it.
All right, I could be sitting at freaking Starbucks drinking a damn coffee and be like, I want to see what the hell is going on my computer, and just freaking one tap remote access straight into my damn computer, and I'm sitting here seeing everything on my phone and what's going on my computer.
Yeah, cool, yeah. Remote.
Oh,
I have that app too.
I don't even use that. I use the straight up Windows remote desktop.
Try cool remote. It's actually much better. It gives you a little bit more control. A little easier too if you want to actually do something on your computer remotely, because you can, it makes it easier to zoom in and zoom out and be able to click and stuff like that. But cool remote's really great.
Is that how you're playing World of Warships?
I like to pull up PowerPoints and Excel. People can email that stuff to me right away. I can edit Excel spreadsheets and send them back. I can view PowerPoints. I can write up Word documents and then access right to my SkyDrive and throw it up there or email it out to people. And not only that, the wireless syncing, I can wireless sync all of my podcasts, just plugging in my phone in the house, using the wireless network will sync everything up for me. So when I walk out the door, everything's all up to date. I've been waiting because I want a Windows Phone 10, and then I heard that they're giving them out. Even if you get a Windows 8 phone, you're going to get the new Windows Phone 10. But I'm kind of waiting for some better hardware because they've been a little stingy on the hardware as of recently. Especially the cameras, because I take a lot of photographs for work. They had a 46 megapixel camera at one point in one of the Nokia line, and then when Microsoft bought them out, that phone disappeared. And now they have some 30s with the Carl Zeiss lenses and stuff like that, but I still need something that's going to be a little higher end than that.
All right, y'all, I'm going to call it. I'm going to go get some rest. I'll see y'all later.
Catch y'all later. User disconnected from your channel. Yeah, I'm not going nowheres. Nowhere.
I'll put it like this. When it comes to the Windows Phone 10, I've been running. I just recently went back to Windows Phone 8.1 update 1. But mainly because one of my apps didn't want to work right. I've been running Windows 10 for phone, the previews, on my 635, and hell, it run better than freaking Windows Phone 8.1.
Yeah, it's definitely more optimized for mobile. I'm still on 7.5. The Nokia 900 was originally a Windows 7 phone. When they upgraded to Windows 8, we all got fucked. We don't get Windows 8, we just got Windows 7.5 because it's only a single processor on the phone.
Ouch.
So I was a little reluctant and a little pissed off, and I was starting to think, you know what, maybe I am going to look at Android phones or something else, because I'm a little pissy about getting left out in the dark, especially a lot of the apps and all the new ones that are coming out are only coming out for Windows
just
Phone 8. You can't get them for 7.5.
How are you?
I don't spend a whole lot of time on my cell phone. So it's not a big, where I'm going to be willing to go out and make a couple $100 investment in a new phone, considering how little time I spend on it, and I spend more time on landlines. So at this point, I'm kind of like, all right, when Windows 10 comes out, I'll find a toy and I'll go get it, and that'll be the end of it.
Well, you see, I actually switched from a HTC Evo 3D, which, I mean, is a great damn phone, but it's getting hard to find shit for the older HTCs. I mean, the damn phone, it'll actually run Android KitKat. It'll actually run Android Lollipop, too, using the custom ROMs. But I just ended up saying screw it because I was able to get the 635 on sale for pretty much next to nothing.
Yeah, Windows has been doing all that off their phones. They're basically giving them away.
I actually got it for $68 with tax.
I actually got my Nokia 900 for free, and they gave me some iHome rechargeable speakers. Like little portable speakers with rechargeable batteries built into them. They were selling them for $100 at the AT&T store. I had to drop $100, but then I got a $100 Visa gift card in the mail. And you got $100 worth of free equipment, so I got the speakers. And so it was like, I got $100 worth of free equipment, I got the phone, I just had to drop $100, and then I got a $100 rebate in the mail.
Okay, there we go.
And I have to tell you, of all of the navigation apps I have ever used, Nokia Drive is the best. I mean, every Navi app, I've tried a bunch of them on different. My wife's got an Android phone. I've tried a bunch of hers. Nothing beats Nokia Maps. Nothing. Especially when you're driving out in the middle of nowhere and can't see shit.
Now, I'll put it like this. Wait till you get your hands on an actual, more recent Windows phone. One that runs Windows Phone 8 or 8.1. Then you get your hands on Hear Plus. Hear Plus is basically the genius child between Nokia's app that you were just talking about and basically a freaking Garmin.
I just killed a Velociraptor.
Well, a combination nice. Between Nokia Drive and Microsoft Scout, which does all the points of interest, and they because it's integrated, because all of that software comes with it, because when I bought it, it wasn't a Windows. Windows didn't own Nokia yet. Nokia was the maker of the device, and then Windows was the software developer, so you got basically software from both, but the two integrated. So it turned out to be a really, really nice situation where you get Scout, they're telling you all of the great restaurants and stuff like that. With one click, it goes right over to Nokia Drive, gives you the directions, and the points of interest are coming up on the Nokia Drive. I don't know if the newer Windows phones, because I think Nokia Drive is gone anyways. I'm assuming Microsoft, since they bought that, they bought everything. So that's probably going to be part of the new, that's probably the standard map program, or Bing Maps, or whatever they want to call it now.
Actually, most Windows phones now, they actually come pre-installed with Hear Drive Plus, and that's actually pretty good. There's actually a couple other different versions of Hear. They even got like Hear Transit Plus, and I can't remember what the other one is. But
Hear Homeless shows you where the Dunkin' Donuts are, so you can go take a piss or take a dump.
Oh jeez.
No. That's more along the lines of that freaking app that come out, Waze, that tells you where all the pigs are. 90% of the time they're at the donut shops. I can't talk too much, though. I spent a short stint in law enforcement. I didn't enjoy it. That's why I got the hell out.
That's funny. I spent a short stint in the custody of law enforcement, and I didn't like it until I got out.
Oh, look at that. You guys both didn't like the law enforcement.
Coming from different sides, hey, I had a logical reason not to like them. They kept me away from things I wanted to do.
I spent time on both sides of the fence on that one, so. But, I mean, when you see a guy get busted for, get busted and sentenced to like 15 years for having like the amount of freaking weed that would fit underneath the freaking pinky nail. Okay, just basically residue and a little bit of crumb, and then give him 15 freaking years and ripping away from his wife and his freaking 3-year-old daughter. I'm sorry, that's bullshit.
In my state, that's a misdemeanor.
Yeah, well, where I was at the time, in the state of Georgia, it was a freaking felony, class A.
Yeah, first time here, it's still a misdemeanor. Second time's a felony for possession.
Yeah, oh, where I'm at, here in Washington State, it's all completely legal. They can't do shit.
Yeah, you can only carry so much, right?
I can have 2 grams on me at any given time.
God damn.
And I can grow up to 6 plants for myself. Leaf can grow 6 for herself.
Germany, you guys are in the wrong spot. You should just come to America. Go to Washington. Start growing. Like, people in Amsterdam have, like, the biggest ridiculous bushes ever, but it's, like, 1 per person. But they grow the craziest weed ever.
For now, I'm just down to the south. I mean, Oregon. Oregon just passed for recreational. And Oregon, they're straight up telling people, hey, you can, if a business establishment says smoking's allowed, they don't care if it's cigarettes or weed.
They're just like, go for it.
Pretty much.
Yeah, there's no smoking in any of my hotels. That's actually by state law. We have a law in the state of Wisconsin that's banned smoking in hotels. And actually, Northern Illinois, they've done the same thing, too. That was just
crazy.
The city itself that did it.
Yeah, what's messed up is a big-ass change for me, because before I came out here to the West Coast, I was actually in Missouri. And in Missouri, you could smoke in bars. Now, I moved out here to Oregon.
What
to
up,
Portland.
Boy Reaper?
His internet probably dropped.
Oh, he was. He was. Oh. Okay. Who's Void? When he, is that one of the guys that's been here forever?
Yeah, that's my brother.
Oh, okay. Ferniner, you get metal just out of stone by chance. I have 3 metal, and I've only gotten maybe 10 metal total the entire time I've been playing. It's a rare source from mining stone with a pickaxe.
Yeah, it's something I read, and you get up to where you can get up. And this is something I was going to mention to you earlier, keep an eye on. When everybody's talking about, you know, make sure you check the inventory on a dino when you knock them out.
Yeah.
I actually, I took out, I think it was a freaking dodo earlier yesterday. Hit the damn thing, had a steel pickaxe in it.
What?
It had a steel freaking pickaxe.
On this server?
Yeah.
What?
Had a steel pickaxe, and from what I read with the steel pickaxes, you actually get a higher chance of getting metal from the rocks when you're mining them.
Wow.
I no more got the damn steel pickaxe, and the big ass bird kills me, and I get respawned in there 3 times as a bird.
Here's the crazy part, I'm about to level up again. I'm at 16. I'm catching up to Bloodcrow.
Hey, you think that's crazy? Wait till we're all running in group and all running to go freaking wipe out a whole area of trees and shit, and the freaking tribe XP bonus starts piling on.
Oh, dude, just I can't with, wait.
Just with me and Bloodcrow freaking harvesting trees, I think we got the freaking multiplier for the XP both of us was getting at almost 3% multiplier.
Wow. Yeah, like, this game definitely encourages team play. Encourages it, guys. So, the more people in your tribe and in your surrounding area together, the better. There's a mammoth. Yep, I'm not going to go fight it. Nope. Nope. I'm going to hurry up and get this meat and then get the fuck out. GTFO. GTFO. I'm still going to go run armaments and armor. Like, that's going to be my main squeeze. I think I'm going to write down a resource calculator, too. Like, what stone and stuff would cost and what different things are, like, in variables. And then break it down into a system. So that way it's like, well, one stone equals this much metal equals this, whatever, like whatever the currency can become, you know what I mean, for trading.
Yep.
And because I'm going to turn myself into a trader for armaments and weapons, or armor. Like, that's what I want to do with my guy.
Yeah, I finally figured out what the hell the rotten meat was for. I was like, what? Because I've been just chucking it, and then I finally got high enough level to where I could learn how to make the narcotic, and I'm looking at the Ingram for it, and I was like, holy crap, with all the freaking narco berries and all this freaking rotten meat I've thrown away, I could have had it easily close to freaking 60 things of freaking narcotic.
What up, Joey Micah? What's going on, bro? How are you, man? We're about to be level 17 here on the VDON server.
And with that freaking narcotic, man, that narcotic, it speeds the taming up. It straight speeds taming up using the narcotic.
Are you around a monster or something? Or a dino?
Who, me?
Yeah.
No, I'm not even in game. I'm just watching your stream. Probably heard my chair squeak.
Stuart, what's up, man? Oh my god, that mammoth moved so far away. Like, I want to move more up this mountain, but I'm afraid to do so now.
Did the mammoth aggro?
I didn't attack it, so I should be good. It's killing something. No, I'm going to run over there. It's going and killing something. Like, I literally saw it just ram something. Please say it's fighting a fucking T-Rex. I want to see this fight. Oh, I'm backing up.
I've seen my god. Take on the T-Rex.
It's fighting something on the ground. Oh! Run, run! Oh my god, I ran into the mammoth I thought I saw. Oh my god, the mammoth, it's stuck.
It's stuck, but it looked like you were wrecking the hell out of that saber tooth.
No, that saber tooth was like on a mammoth that was way off in the distance, and I was watching it fight it, and I ran up on it, and that saber tooth almost turned around on me. It was aggro. Yeah. I've got all this resource and material, and I don't want to die. I'm slowly making it up the mountain.
That's when you go to some random location, pull up your map, freaking figure out where you're at, hit P, put a marker on your freaking map, using the latitude longitude coordinates from your map book, and freaking drop you a freaking storage chest to start putting shit in.
Let's see. Simple bed. How much do I need? Oh, I need 40 hide, so I need 38 more hide. I can get everything else easy, but I need hide. Joey Micah, no, I'm not depressed. I'm actually speaking quiet because it's 6:49 here in the morning, and my entire family, both my kids and my wife, are asleep, so I have to talk low. I don't want to wake anybody up. My son had a very long day. If he gets up this time, he's going to be super fucking cranky, and that pisses off the wife and me. My daughter, she's cool like 99% of the time. It's rare she has a bad day. You're just logging into Ark? Stuart, oh my god, you've missed 30 hours of me playing Ark. It's all on YouTube though. 30-hour stream, guys. 2 hours of which was me logging in. That didn't go up. OBS bugged out, disconnected, and then reconnected, so it created a separate video. Let's see. Give me a second. I gotta log back in to see if the server is active yet.
Yeah, according to the ClanPay page, it's still saying pending install.
Yeah, I'm going to it right now. Or at least trying to log in. I'm wondering if it's because we're all logging in under the same
No, I'm not even logged in. I'm just looking at the ClanPay page where you can go and drop money on the account using PayPal. It actually says down there service 40 players Ark Survival Evolved pending install in Dallas.
I can't log in now. Really? I can't fucking log in?
What the hell?
Don't tell me now their page is going down for maintenance or some shit. Yeah, this is gonna piss me off. Okay, really? I bet you right now Steam is literally, because right now I'm looking at it, Steam is probably running off the servers from game servers, and it's literally $70.65 for 70 players. And all those official servers are 70 players, so they're probably buying them all from game servers.
I still don't know how there's people running freaking servers for over 100 damn players.
Because
I haven't seen a
server provider
hosting any more than
70. The official servers, they're getting them from other websites. Or they're getting them from game servers. The unofficial servers are going to anyone who has the highest amount of server load up. The more player, you know, the most players possible. So some people have 127. You're level 27 and have not gotten one medal, you sure? Yeah, Ferniner. Just so you know, you may want to have the newest updates. There's also a thing called a spyglass that you can make. You gotta harvest crystal for it. All sorts of crazy stuff. Yep, I can't log in. Says member invalid login and or password. Oh.
Maybe they're updating the status of it, and that's why you're not getting able to log into it, because they're updating to let you know it's ready to go.
Oh my god. Ugh, fuckers. Either that, or Blood Crow's going to have to wake up and see that it's been accessed from multiple computers, and it's going to say something like, you've logged in from a different access point. Please change your password. Joey, Micah, thank you for the follow. Thank you for the support, my friend. Thank you so much. Hell yeah.
I messed up.
Alright, guys, we're going to run 2000 GC giveaway. So enter for your chances to win, guys. Hell yeah. Get up this mountain a bit. Oh shit. I'm starting to have problems getting up the mountain. Oh shit.
That was a bit of a glitch.
Yeah.
Sorry, I got stuck in the damn rocks where we have that one base. I got stuck in the freaking rocks, in the dark, couldn't see nothing. I just started wildly swinging my pickaxe till I started hitting the rock and busted out a chunk of rock to get loose.
Yeah, you can't get up the side of a mountain. I think I've entered that point where you get so far up in the game. Like, you climb a mountain so far up that it's not possible. Alright, I'm gonna sit here and regen health.
Ark Survival Evolved lets you live out your Jurassic Park fantasy.
Hell yeah, Ark lets you live out your Jurassic Park fantasy? I believe it.
Hell yeah.
That's like before the last rollback for that patch. I actually put up a wood billboard out in front of the base. Jurassic Park brought to you by Blood Nation.
Oh my god, I'm about to level up again. Oh, I gotta pee so bad, guys. I will be right back. Alright, here's that timer, guys. It's got 10 minutes, so guys, get in on that GC giveaway. Look at that. Oh no, my health is going down.
Yeah, you're injured and you're freezing.
Really? I died. There it went. There it went. I'm going pee. Fuck it.
God damn it.
I just died.
Eh, it happens to the best of us. Just hope you don't get a shitty respawn.
I don't see anything that can kill me yet. Be right back. Okay, I'm back. Hell yeah, I'm back.
Welcome back.
You're welcome.
User joined your channel.
What up, Zwizzy?
Oh, he knew. Just because of my gas.
No, I actually have TeamSpeak open on my third monitor.
Fine, Derek. You seem to me like that.
Yeah. Oh, I'm sorry. I got to. I have to look over. Special. You are special.
Special. What
are you playing, buddy? Ferniner. Yes, I have a base with Bloodcrow, but because he's not on, I can't join the tribe unless someone's an admin. And on top of that, every time I've gone over there, I've died. I've died somehow by something. It's either those flying birds with feathers, fucking saber-tooths, a badass scorpion, a fucking raptor, the spitter dudes, like everything finds me.
What is an Ark?
Yes, I'm playing Ark.
What is that?
Ark is like Rust or Reign of Kings, but it has dinosaurs and it's badass.
So it's really fun?
Put it bluntly, I streamed it for 30 hours straight, and here I am after that day of streaming. And 15 hours of sleep, I'm back at it again.
So, yes. Is it like multiplayer world or is it?
It's
like
MMO. It's MMO world.
Wow.
It's the first. Honestly, I can say it's the first MMO that's not zombie. And it's worth getting.
How much is it?
It's like on sale right now. 17% on Steam.
How much is it?
It's like $27 or $23.45. It's actually worth it though. It's worth every bit.
Yeah, it's running right now. $24.89.
Well, after this game of League, I might buy it and join you. If you will give me permission to join you. Senpai, please?
Like, I wish I had Bloodcrow's phone number. Scott, call Bloodcrow.
I don't have his telephone number.
I'm sure you can get it. You have your ways.
You don't stalk him? Why not? I stalk everybody.
Bloodcrow or Scott Plant, I'm sure you have your ways of getting that info.
I do, but it's not worth the effort or the money.
Damn it.
Or the bitching out of Crow when he gets woke the fuck up.
Nah, I'm not worried about that.
No, it's the legal issues that we will have. That is the real problem.
I want